Hi, welcome to the bathtub. This is Scott Bradfield, the old masturbator. We masturbate straight through the entire Trump administration. Sometimes we masturbate once or twice a day during the Trump administration, and we're planning to masturbate straight through the Joe Biden both terms. I don't think Joe Biden's going to be doing a lot of masturbating. He's getting pretty old, and you know his hands are going to be tired because he's signing a lot of stuff. But we're going to try to get through another 8 years of the bathtub. I was thinking the other day when we did our endless 200th episode. This is now officially our 201st episode of the bathtub. And we started this years ago, basically after Trump got elected, and I really didn't think we'd survive the 4 years. So we barely survived. I'm still not sure if we really did survive, but we got through it anyway. And today we're going to do a few short ones in the next couple of weeks. Just to get going again, you see, I brought my pink shirt out because I want to treat this like an important day. It's 201st episode. We're closing on 2,000 subscribers, and we don't do anything on the show. We literally don't do anything important here at all. So what I've been reading is basically all this is what I've been reading lately, and what I've been reading lately over several weeks really is Robert Aichman's collection of stories, The Unsettled Dust. And Robert Aichman, we've talked about Robert Aichman in the past. We did a longish piece. This was first published in 1990. All right. And we've talked about Robert Aichman. What I've done over the, what I did when I first did a piece on him about 3 or 4 years ago now, because the New York Review of Books published this thing called Compulsory Games, which was a number of his stories and essays and some unpublished material, most of which had come out with Tartarus. I think all of it had come out with Tartarus Press. Tartarus Press in somewhere up in Yorkshire in England has been doing some lovely editions of all the old Aichman collections and doing a new collection. And Aichman is really kind of this brilliant short story writer of the 60s, 70s, and 80s particularly, I think. He wrote almost exclusively short stories. You can go back and see my longer piece on him from a while back. But when I was working on that, I basically just kind of browsed around. So I was trying to read a lot of Aichman over a few months when I was doing a piece about him. And it's a great way of getting to know a writer. But as we say here at the bathtub, what we really try to do is read the single author collections that authors put together in their lifetime, because they have a certain straight shape and an integrity to them, which I really like. I much prefer the editions that they put together themselves to the, say, complete short story collections, however wonderful those are, from people like Tartarus or Hippocampus, I think, did one, or Centipede, one of those people. There are people who put out complete collections of his stories. At the same time, those are really hard to read. They kind of don't have the integrity of a nice collection. And so what I've been doing is rereading and reading for the first time some of his stories. And I'm going back to his original collections that he put together himself. The Unsettled Dust is a good example of what one of the problems of reading these collections is, that Aichman, like many short story writers, he published a book of stories every 5, 6, 8 years. And he was often trying to get his old books and old stories in print when he was alive. So he often reprints stories. Many of the collections reprint certain stories that are in other collections. But at the same time, they still have a nice shape to them. And I'll just say briefly what it is I like about that shape. For example, there's 8 stories here. Aichman writes kind of horror stories, fantasy stories, slightly surreal stories. They're very narrative. They're very funny. They're very odd. I think he called his stuff strange fiction, strange stories. And strange stories works better than horror stories. And yet he kind of ranges across a number of different types of strange stories. For example, the opening story in here is called The Unsettled Dust. And Aichman does something that I like about short story writers. He writes kind of longish stories. So they're like 30, 40 pages often. Sometimes, as in the Stains, the concluding story in this book, 70 to 80 pages. They're longish stories. They really wrap you up, and then they close the door. And I like that. I like that effect. I much prefer those to, say, 4 or 5-page stories or 10-page stories, kind of a long story that kind of really gets you into and really wraps you up. When you see the writer put his collection together, you see him frame the book. So, for example, in the first story, The Unsettled Dust is a longish ghost story, slightly more conventional than the other stories, but at the same time, you can really never use the word conventional for Aikman. His stuff is just too odd. And there's a long ghost story at the beginning with a ghost in it. And then you have The Stains, which I have read before. It is a really spectacular story about a man who meets this girl in the woods who is collecting lichen. I don't think I pronounced it right. Lichen or lichen, the stains on rocks, these types of fungus. And he becomes involved with her, and she has a father. And it's a long, complicated story. I won't describe it very much. But it has a very kind of haunting, odd, unusual quality to it, and it's quite disturbing. It's quite scary in many ways. The opening story, The Unsettled Dust, is probably the best story in the book, and it is sort of a ghost story. It's about a man who works for kind of a heritage preservation society that Aikman himself did, because he was involved with the Inland Waterways in London. And it's about a guy who goes out to this house, and these elderly, this couple, these women, they're not that elderly, these women who have an old estate, and he's with an organization that helps preserve those estates and basically takes them over so that this couple is actually living in this house that's owned by the government. And when he goes into this old house from the past, the place is covered with like a thick layer of dust. And every time he goes in, there's this thick layer of dust. And that's the first image and the controlling image of the whole story. There is a ghost that appears. There's a kind of a dust storm that occurs. And what often happens in Aikman is you don't have the explanation. You don't have the explanation of what's really happened. He the central character of the story learns all this information about the past and these women's personal lives and what happened years ago and the death of a young man. And at one point, there's every Aikman story has an idea I've never seen before. There is a ghost appears in the story. It's quite a disturbing scene. And a ghost shows up, and he sort of sees it go by him. He looks in the window, and he sees the reflection of the ghost, and then it disappears. And the maid comes in, the woman who's worked in the house for years, and he says, "I saw this figure," and she said, "Yeah, it happened. Everybody does." Basically, she says, "Yeah, it happens," and he says, "That's kind of disturbing." She says, "You don't have to worry about it. Nobody sees the ghost more than once." What a great idea. It just sent chills down my back when I hit that section. The stories don't come to resolutions as far as the plot and why things are happening, but they do come to a sort of emotional resolution. And the opening stories and the closing story of this book are sort of the frame that hold the book together. Now, at the same time, the stories that it contains six other stories, some of which I've read and some which I haven't. The Houses of the Russians, which is a bit of a ghost story. Something called No Stronger Than a Flower, and one called The Next Glade. And those are the stories that I have to say I quite like about Aikman. He writes kind of weird relationship stories. And the story called is a No Stronger Than a Flower is a good example, which is about a man who marries a woman and he sort of loves her, I guess. The relationships are these weird British relationships where people are just totally embarrassed by each other and their physical attractions to one another. And he meets this woman and he marries her and he starts to think that she should be prettier. And he wants her to go to see somebody to make herself prettier. And she starts to do things like get her hair fixed and wear makeup. At one point, she starts wearing veils. And I can't really describe the story, but it's about the process by which this relationship totally breaks down. And this woman becomes more and more strange and more estranged from this man, this husband. The other story, The Next Glade, is one of my favorite Aikman stories. It's about a woman who meets a man at a party. She's married. She meets a man at a party, and this man keeps kind of showing up in her life, and she finds him living out in the woods. She lives in some place like one of these kind of woodsy towns in London, out on the outskirts of London. I don't know, Petswood or somewhere like that. And there's a kind of woods out there, and she goes out there and she finds him living in some old shack out there. And at the same time, her husband goes for a walk with her, and he suddenly dies. There's lots of incidents in an Aickman story where things happen that you never really know why they happen, but they make a sort of logical, dreamlike sense. And the story progresses about her relationship to this man who's not, who she doesn't even know his name. I think he keeps changing his name. The Next Glade is a story that really knocked me out. I mean, I've read it twice now, and I liked it both times. There's a slightly more conventional horror story in the middle called the, I don't know, the Cicerones, which is about a guy visiting a church. I think he's in Belgium or he's a tourist somewhere, and who encounters a very peculiar and disturbing event. And it is a horror story. That's the closest to a horror story in the book. Anyway, I didn't want to talk too long about it. I just wanted to say that reading this collection of stories has its problems because Aickman does all of his collections seem to repeat stories from other collections, and yet at the same time they kind of belong together in each edition. So I would suggest going out. I think Faber's reprinted a lot of these, and there's some of them are in print, some aren't. But I would say this is a very good one to start. My favorite one so far is probably The Wine Dark Sea, but at the same time, you can't go wrong if you get a collection of stories by Robert Aickman, one of the great. He's a strange story writer. I don't think you can call him horror stories. At the same time, I also started reading this. I've never been a ghost story fan before, but as I said, in the past couple of years, I've kind of become more interested in kind of horror writers and H.P. Lovecraft type stuff. And H. Aickman edited the series for Fontana in England called the Fontana Book of Great Ghost Stories. And he's collected. He has like a little introduction at the beginning of each edition, and there's a lot of stories in here. I don't think I've read any of these stories. The one I just finished, which is about the ghost ship, it's about a little town, some rural English town, where ghosts just happen to be all over the place. The people in the town are just used to ghosts being around. It's a story called The Ghost Ship by Richard Middleton. Anyway, I'm kind of enjoying these. I probably do maybe do a report on those the Fontana. The Fontana Book of Great Ghost Stories that Aickman edited. I think he edited a dozen of them, maybe quite a few of them over the years. Happy bathing. Congratulations to those of us who survived the Trump administration. And we'll try to keep these going. We're heading towards 2,000 subscribers. We're going to do something really special. It's going to be very special when we hit the 2,000th subscriber. Stay safe. Stay in the bathtub. I'll tell you when it's safe to come out.